Hey there, everyone. This week, we're talking about something funny that has happened because of our LGBT status. Something kind of funny happened last week. I'm not sure if it's funny or weird, but I think maybe both, and it's close enough to remember. At my work, one of the things that we do is we write funding proposals in order to be able to deliver services to people. And generally that process works by an individual that works within the organisation, writes a funding proposal, costs it, puts the budget forward, sends it off, and if it becomes shortlisted, it depends on the funding body. So you may have to go to an interview with the funding body or give a presentation or whatever the format is. And the most obvious thing to do, right, is for the person that wrote the funding proposal to go to that shortlisted process, whatever it may be, for the simple reason that they can answer the questions under fire. However, this is always a contentious issue, okay? But my opinion of this is these people desperately need these services. So in my mind, and all the statistics show, that the best person to send is someone who reflects the people that you're presenting to. So if it was a Christian organisation, send a Christian. If it was a workplace largely with women, send a woman. If it's male-dominated, send a man, you know. Because I kind of think it's no time for political correctness when people need something, you know. We're not doing this for ourselves. And so, yeah, I just don't think it's any time to be promoting diversity, you know. Now, many people disagree with that point. However, that's what this is around. So we had put forward a funding proposal that I had written for an organisation, let's just say an extremely male-dominated organisation that was had funding up. And so I said to my work, okay, let me explain what I've done here to a man and you send them to this shortlisting process, because it was an interview process as well. And they didn't agree. They wanted me to go. So I thought, okay, I really don't think it's the best option, but fine. You know, they pay me. So I turned up at this interview, and it was the normal kind of thing that you go through with funding proposals. And I always, in my work, I mean, the people I work closely with know me well, but with people that I'm only going to see briefly or with people that actually need things, I brush over my personal life very quickly if it comes up. And because really those situations have nothing to do with me. And in fact, if I start discussing me, that's just a distraction from what the point is, you know? So it's not really LGBT status that I would discuss or not discuss. However, if someone asks me directly, I'm not going to sit there and lie, and I'll say something offhand and keep moving. Somehow in this discussion, one of the people on the panel brought up their wife, and this, and somehow someone ended up saying, well, are you married? And I said, no, I'm not married. And he made a joke, in all good humour, you know, that if he had to suffer, then everyone else should be married kind of thing, or something like that. And I said, well, look, I'm not legally able to be married. And then the other person on the panel said, well, I wouldn't have been able to tell that from your writing. And I'm thinking, that's weird, right? I mean, I've heard of a lot of LGBT stereotypes, but how people write, I don't know. But as I said, I just kept moving because, hey, anything that moved away from that funding proposal, like, do we care? But in my head, I was thinking, that's pretty weird. And then we got sort of towards the end, and he said to me, you do realise that you may need to get, if this proposal is successful, you may need to get someone else to sign off on it, because you have to be an Australian citizen to sign off on this funding, like to put the proposal in. And I said, oh, well, I've been an Australian citizen for like over 10 years. You know, that's not an issue. I can sign it. And then he looked at me strangely and he said, but I thought you said you couldn't legally get married. I'm like thinking this is the worst time that this could happen, right? Because like, I'm not really the person that should be presenting this thing in the first place. And I'm thinking, oh, what the hell? It's going to fall over anyway. And I said, no, I said, I meant I was gay. And then he looks at me again and he burst out laughing. And he was almost crying. And I couldn't work it out. And I was thinking, that's a bit strange. This whole thing is just weird, you know. And then when he stopped laughing, he said, oh, he said, I just assumed, you know, that when you said you weren't a citizen, that you couldn't get married. And he said, now you're turning around and you're telling me that, you know, you're a woman from an ethnic background, you're a migrant, and you're also gay, and you've come in here to put this funding proposal in. And because, you know, as I said, it's a very male-dominated organisation, and very, like, conservative. And I couldn't help but laugh. I said, look, I know. I told them, you know, I said, trust me, I rattled off the stats on this. I told them, because by this stage I'm thinking we don't have it anyway. What difference does it make, you know? And he turned around. He said, I'm just stunned you did it. He said, you've got the funding. It's yours. We'll email it. It's not. And it was an extremely, I assumed, because there is so much discussion around marriage equality in Australia all the time because we don't have it and there's an election on, that me saying I can't legally get married is a quick, non-confronting way to say, I don't do the heterosexual thing. So, and it's worked before. And when I've wanted to either test the water or say something without confronting people directly, it's worked before. It's never been, people have always picked it up as, oh, you're gay, you know, you can't get married. So, yeah, I wasn't expecting someone to go, oh, no, she's not a citizen and she's just written this funding proposal. Like, you know. I mean, what was he thinking, sitting there for 20 minutes taking a, like, funding proposal from an illegal immigrant? It was very strange. Anyway, it all turned out well in the end. I'm going to run away. Thank you for watching. Tell us if anything funny's happened to you and, well, tell me anything, really. And have a wonderful week. I'll see you next week. Bye for now.